We couldn't find her.
We arrived at her house. We found a package. I saw a triangle-shaped figure that looked much like... where is it? Oh, man. There's a drawing on one side of the box. I forget where it was. Maybe on the bottom. So, I turn around. I see Miss Joy. I don't tell my mom. And Miss Joy comes up and goes... And my mom jumps basically out of her shoes, except not because... Because it's not like that. It's not the cartoon. Anyways. So, we... arrived at approximately 1:30. We went in. We had Miss Joy got reminded of her friend who she helped. How do I say this without making it sound weird?
Die
easier. I was gonna try to find a different word, but dispose just makes it sound even worse.
Definitely.
Okay.
Dying is not a dirty word, baby.
Okay. So, after we found the box of crystals, I started to create some healing fireballs. I mixed white, which is purification, pink, which is love, and green, which is peace and love. And I sent it all at her. Hoping she would feel better.
It helped a lot.
Alright. It helped a lot.
Yeah.
Then, she was worried about the crystals, and they appeared to have been very traumatized.
No kidding.
By her husband, who would soon lose the house, or has already.
So we sent him lots of love.
Yes. But then we refocused our attention back on the crystals. So, Miss Joy wished for me to set up a, I want to say quarantine, but that's not the right word.
Sacred space?
Sacred space, thank you. For the crystals, so that I may wash them in that space. Now, this was the hardest challenge I've had yet. And with coming here late, it took quite long.
Why was it the hardest challenge?
Because I was basically doing pretty much the same thing over and over, and I was going insane. Let me elaborate more. So, we had to, or I set up this sacred space. I was going to set up a circle with these rocks out there, if you want to look.
Serpentine.
Yeah, serpentine rocks. And so I decided to make a heart formation instead. I asked which pieces of sacred objects would be necessary for the sacred space. For the cleaning. The cleansing. And so, basically... once I had all of the objects, Miss Joy said to find objects to represent the houses of the WPA. Yeah, I remember it as WPA. Very easily.
Can you sit?
Sorry.
Oh.
Walking while I'm talking helps me talk. So? So, the houses are House Gaia.
Not me, I'm having a bedtime story.
House Oceana. House Solar and House Luna. House Gaia was probably the easiest to use. I represented this statue of a green man, or at least the face of him, and represented as the House of Gaia.
He's actually the green man.
The green man.
Just a green man.
Representing the House of Gaia,
yep,
which
male
is just
aspect of Mother Earth.
Representing the North. Pretty easy. I had to actually use my phone's compass to find where it was, that north was. Then I went to south, which was also easy. And south, which is, okay, the south is, nope. The object used for House Oceania is the power shell. Am I right?
Power shell, that's it.
Power shell.
Mm-hmm.
Not power, it's power.
Power. P-A-U-A. Americans call it abalone. I think it's a wee bit different, but very, very similar.
Okay. So, very easy. Represents the South, Oceania, and the power shell.
Element of water.
Yes, element of water. Gaia is the element of earth.
Mm-hmm.
Next is solar, House Solar, which if you are good at guessing the elements, probably guessed fire.
Unlike our head boy here.
Okay,
who did not guess fire.
I didn't guess anything.
But instead guessed 20 other things, which may or may not be related to fire or House Solar.
Okay, Mom, do you have the list?
Yes.
Yeah, we don't have that much time.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't
right.
have that much time.
Got it.
You're going through 20 items.
So, I was trying to find an item to represent House Solar, representing the East. I could not find an item. I searched 20 items that all were representing something to do with the sun at first, with ring not pass,
the
ring not pass, the ring pass not,
yep,
the ring, the Pringle pass. Okay, anyways, so after a while, I just kind of stopped finding objects related to sun and stars and fire, and so I just went with anything that was red. I started grabbing random items. I was going insane because I kept doing practically the same thing over and over. And yes. So, I actually found out that this was the appropriate sacred object to use for House Solar.
It was right
in front of my nose, in the center of the heart where I put it.
Mm-hmm.
So ironic. How
long did it take you to find that under your nose?
21 objects.
How many hours?
How many hours?
Two.
No.
No.
Three.
You wish.
No.
Four. Five. Six. Moving on. Anyways. So, House Lunar. As you may have guessed, last element is air. So I was also having trouble finding an object to represent House Lunar, which is the party house and romance. So I found...
No, was it the moon for House Lunar? Did you find the moon, a moonly thing? Perhaps a nice night sky?
No.
A star?
I was thinking about ring pass not, but that's the sun. Anyways, so I found this feather, which looked like it could be used for dancing and somehow for attracting birds. So, yeah. I tried to put it to stand it up because it's a humongous feather, about this big, long. And I ended up having to use paper, rocks, and a thumbtack.
and it didn't work. It's way big. Okay. Anyways, point is, I found, or actually my mom found this ribbon, which is light as air, so that's one thing it's good for. It's also used for dancing, ribbon dancing, and then can be attracted for romance. And so that's basically how it went, but I still haven't cleansed the stones. That's what we're gonna do tomorrow. And they all lived happily ever after.
What did you learn?
I learned that insanity comes from doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results.
What else did you learn?
I also learned that Gaia has a male personality.
A male aspect.
That's... Yep. Yeah.
Green man, yep.
That's
what
I meant.
What else did you learn?
I also learned that PowerShell is not spelt with a W, but rather a U.
Mm-hmm.
And I learned that it's never good to just completely grab any object that's red and suppose that it's a sacred object.
Mm-hmm. What else?
I learned that the answers to life may be right under my nose.
Yeah. Good. What else?
I learned if I try something 20 times and it doesn't work, I'm doing something wrong.
What else?
If you disturb Miss Joy enough, she won't talk to you.
Okay.
Being a good app is very important. I was not a very good app to my mom today.
Say more.
I was kind of having a breakdown because I was going insane with the solar, house solar. The thing I probably could have done different is switched over to house lunar in the middle of it. That would have probably helped, but I wasn't. Sorry for being a jerk and not cooperating. Anyways.
What will you change next time?
Finding the problem and drawing out the solutions.
How many?
At least 5. And if I can find more than 20, then I may have to use my app's fingers and toes. Yes!
You may not remove the fingers and toes, however, I'm just saying.
Okay.
What else?
I just had something really good.
Was it about the chair top?
No. Don't limit your
options.
Perspective objects to something in a particular area.
How could that apply to more of your life?
Don't only look at one area of your life. No, that's not good at all. Don't. Okay. Bad thing. Okay. I forgot what I was talking about.
You completely restricted yourself even after I told you that you could search out other objects. You held on to a belief system that the only objects that were available were on that chair.
Yeah. So, expand your horizons for future reference.
That's a good one.
Reset. CAD reset. Control Alt Delete reset.
Yes.
And it's basically where you go like this. I'm gonna go right here. You could stop it if you want. It's very long.
It's very long. You're not.
Do you really want to go over that
Just
right
snap
now?
it.
Or
Just
just